Using the SOA Debugger in JDeveloper. This is the third video in our three-part series, SOA Suite 12C Developer Productivity. We will show you how to debug a SOA composite application by setting breakpoints in the composite editor, bpill process, and service bus pipeline using Oracle JDeveloper. This video is a brief overview of the SOA Debugger in JDeveloper. See the Developing SOA Applications with Oracle SOA Suite document at the URL listed for more information. And note that debugging is limited to the design view in Oracle JDeveloper. To get started, we have a deployed project open. To set breakpoints in the composite, right-click an interface and select Create Breakpoint Pair. The breakpoints appear as little red icons with an arrow pointing in the direction of the flow. The breakpoint pair is useful for scenarios in which both the request and reply are important. Now let's expand the bpill process. In a bpill process, right-click an activity and select Toggle Breakpoint. This will set a breakpoint if there is none and remove if there is already a breakpoint. These breakpoints are red dots only without an arrow, as the flow is always in one direction. Set as many breakpoints as you want. Now start the debugger for your project. You can either click the red debugger icon to start the debugger or right-click the project and select Debug. You can debug local or remote actions. When the debugger is started, a window pops up asking which server you want to use for debugging. Choose your host and leave the defaults. Click OK. The debugger is ready when you see this message. Every web service endpoint now shows a message so that you can use the context menu to initialize web service debugging. Right-click the web service interface and select Initiate Web Service Debugging. This opens the HTTP analyzer. Fill in all fields or choose HTTP content at the bottom to be able to copy and paste an XML file instead. You can test HTTP requests and responses in a SOA composite application with the HTTP analyzer in Oracle JDeveloper. The HTTP analyzer enables you to examine the content of HTTP request response package pairs. You can edit the content of a request package, resend it, and observe the response packet returned. Click Send Request. If everything goes well, you should now see the debugger stop at your first breakpoint. The active breakpoint turns blue and starts pulsing. Go to the Data tab at the bottom of JDeveloper and look at your variable values. Step over or use F8 to start your bpill process. Step through the bpill process one activity at a time using F8 and see how the variable values change. If you step through an assign activity, you will see the debugger step through the copy rules that are included in that assign. If you set a breakpoint at the database adapter, it will jump out of bpill and back to the composite. Note the values that come back from the adapter. After the calculate payment activity, the payment status has been set. See what happens when you modify a value. On the left-hand side, you also see the stack trace. Finish the debugger by stepping to the end of your bpill process. Back in the HTTP analyzer, you can see the result of the request response activity. Make sure to terminate the debugger before you continue with the implementation. As long as the debugger is running, you will not be able to edit. To stop the debugger, click the big red icon in the Tools section and select your project. Then click Terminate. This concludes our three-part developer productivity series. For more information on working with SOA Suite 12C, see oracle.com/OLL/SOA.